This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. The Typhoon-class submarine could stay submerged for 120 days in uneventful conditions. However, that amount could be further increased if necessary, especially in the potential outbreak of a nuclear war. The type was conceived at the peak of the Cold War, at a time when submarines had a clear objective: to convey nuclear missiles. By the 1970s, the Soviet Navy resolved to undertake a massive program known as Project 941 Akula. The idea was to create an underwater craft capable of carrying as many nuclear weapons as possible. As such, at 175 meters long, the Typhoon became the largest nuclear submarine to ever roam the seas. Raid Shadow Legends is an ambitious cross-platform game, available now for iOS, Android, and PC. Raid Shadow Legends allows you to choose your personal champion from a pool of more than 600 warriors. Battle dozens of enemies in campaigns with beautiful landscapes, or fight head-to-head against other players in different arenas. The Dark Seas team has achieved victory after victory with powerful champions such as Whirlam Frost King, towering giant with devastating freezing attacks, Gala Longbraids, a dwarf master with tremendous strike abilities, and Jintoro, a samurai-like champion armed with a lightning katana. Raid has just released a brand new faction, the Sylvan Watchers, with its unique arsenal of champions with new abilities and gameplay tactics. These new champions could be your allies or your foes in the next match you hop into. And if that's not enough, Raid's got a full lineup of events, including a new season of the Forge Pass, where you can get your hands on some of the most powerful gear the game has ever seen. If you're an Amazon Prime member, you can get your exclusive rewards in Raid right now. If you've not started playing Raid, you can click the link in the description to get unique bonuses worth over $30. This special pack includes 200,000 silver, one energy refill, one experience boost, one ancient shard, and the champion, Tyrell. Soviet austerity. In the 1970s, the USSR launched the Typhoon program, a codename for the new nuclear weapons plan. The endeavor sought to create a submarine capable of launching new nuclear missiles. But equally as important, the powerful vessels had to be capable of remaining at sea for months on end in case a nuclear war broke out. The resulting Typhoon class, or Project 941 Akula under Soviet designation, was a nuclear-powered ballistic submarine that was 175 meters long, 23 meters in beam, and 12 meters in draft. It remains the largest class of submarines ever built, with an impressive 48,000 tons of submerged displacement. Not to be confused with the NATO codenamed Akula vessels that are actually the Stuka B-class attack submarines, the Typhoons were specially conceived with the objective of matching the SLBM armament of the American-made Ohio-class submarines. Moreover, the craft had to accommodate comfortable living spaces for a complement of 160, who would be submerged for as long as 120 days under normal conditions. Otherwise austere in amenities, the Typhoon ships had room for the engineers at St. Petersburg's Rubin Design Bureau to include unprecedented perks. Their sheer size made it even possible to squeeze in a solarium, a swimming pool, and a sauna. Armament. The SSBN Typhoon-class missiles were designed by the Makayev Design Bureau and were given the NATO designation SSN-20 Sturgeon. Each consisted of 10 independently targetable multiple reentry vehicles, or MIRVs, and weighed 84,000 kilograms at launch, carrying a 100 kiloton nuclear warhead. The Ohio-class submarines are able to carry 102 nuclear warheads of 100 kilotons each, and the Typhoon-class would also carry 20 RSM-52 intercontinental three-stage ballistic missiles. Unsurprisingly, the Soviets aimed to give their missiles an enhanced range, and in order to accommodate the improved variant, Soviet SLBMs had to be substantially larger and heavier than their Western counterparts. In truth, the Sturgeon is more than twice as heavy as the UGM-96 Trident 1, remaining the heaviest SLBM to have ever served. And as such, the vessel had to be scaled. Their guidance system was inertial, with stellar reference updating, and their range stretched to 8,300 kilometers, enabling them to easily target the United States with an accuracy of 500 meters. Besides the missiles, the class included 6 torpedo tubes, 4 630mm tubes, and 2 533mm tubes, for a total of 22 anti-submarine projectiles of varying types, such as the Type 53 torpedo and the RPK-2 missile. Moreover, Typhoons could fire their primary weapon system and deploy their R-39 SLBMs while moored at their docks, making them a significantly powerful platform. Typhoon. The origin for NATO's reporting name for the class is unclear. It is said that the word Typhoon was used by General Secretary Leonid Brezhnev of the Communist Party back in 1974, when describing the new type of nuclear ballistic missile submarine in reaction to the US Navy's Ohio class, unknowingly baptizing the entire fleet. The Soviet SSBN class design features a multi-hull design with no less than 5 inner hulls. These were situated inside a superstructure comprising the 2 parallel main hulls, which in turn were coated with sound-absorbent tiles. In the center, the 3rd smaller hull above the main hulls protruded just below the sail. This characteristic significantly increased the Typhoon's menacing appearance, as their sail, or conning tower, did not conceal the missile silos, and their imposing mines always appeared in pictures. The multiple pressure hulls simplified the internal design, but made the ship notoriously more wide than average submarines. However, they also increased the overall survivability of the entire vessel. If any pressure hull was breached, the crew in the next one was safer and under less risk of flooding. Furthermore, the design included icebreaking features, as well as technology for traveling under the ice. The submarines also showcased an advanced stern fin, a horizontal hydroplane, and retractable nose horizontal hydroplanes. Additional retractable gear included 2 periscopes, a radio sextant, radio communications, navigation, and direction finder masts. Consequently, the type was able to dive as deep as 400 meters and reach a maximum speed of 25 knots when submerged. In contrast, its cruising speed was 12 knots. Most importantly, the type was unquestionably larger than its American competitors. Although the Typhoons were only 17 feet longer than the Ohio's, they were substantially wider and taller. Possibilities. In total, Russia built 6 Typhoons between 1976 and 1985. The ships were initially designated by hull numbers only, but the 4 vessels retained by the Russian Navy and sponsored by either a city or a company later received proper names. The class's lead ship, TK-208, was later named Dmitry Donskoy, and she entered service in 1981. Then followed TK-202, known as Simbirsk, TK-13, known as Arkhangelsk, and Severstal in 1989. The construction order for a 7th vessel, TK-210, was cancelled and never completed. There was an initiative in the early 1990s to refurbish some of the submarines into cargo vessels for shipping oil, gas, and other materials. The idea was to exploit the type's inherent underpolar capabilities so they could travel to the country's far-flung northern territories. The colossal ships could take up to 10,000 tons of cargo and ship it with ease under the ice casket in the Barents Sea. Still, the oil could only be delivered around the world after the considerable engineering process to transfer it from the drilling platforms to the submarines and then to the waiting tankers was fully functional. The class was stationed with the Russian Northern Fleet at Litsaguba. Only Donskoy received a refit and was relaunched in 2002 as a trial ship. As for Arkhangelsk and Severstal, they were decommissioned between 2004 and 2006 and placed on reserve, while their sisters TK-2 and TK-13 were ultimately scrapped. In 2011, the Defense Ministry decided to write off all Project 941 submarines until 3 years later, as Russia had several restrictions as part of the Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty. Besides, they were to be replaced by the Beret class. Last survivor. The United States assisted in the Cooperative Threat Reduction Program, which had nuclear fuel from TK-202 removed in US-funded processing facilities. She was then converted for long-term storage and reuse, and the UK also took part in the process. Donskoy spent her post-Cold War career as a testbed for the new generation of Russian submarine technologies, and was transferred to the Baltic to participate in the 2017 Main Naval Parade, which was held in Kronstadt. As the behemoth that she is, the submarine was instrumental in testing the next intercontinental ballistic missile in the Russian Navy's inventory. The solid-fueled Bulava SS NX-32 ballistic missile was developed while the older R-39 was retired. Reportedly, Bulava has a range of over 8,000 kilometers, but unlike its predecessor, it can carry a 550-kiloton nuclear warhead. Based on the land-launched Topol missile, the weapon was to arm the newer Beret class, but was also retrofitted to the Typhoon. The Navy eventually canceled the Typhoon modernization program, arguing that upgrading a single vessel in the class would be as expensive as building two new Berets from scratch. As such, Russia also eliminated the last R-39 SLBMs. The only Typhoon in active service was thus outfitted with the more modern RSM-56 Bulava, and continued in operation until 2022. It was previously stated that the submarine would remain in service until 2026 in her role as a weapons test platform, but it is rumored that the ship was decommissioned in July. Still, other sources claim that a final decision on her fate will not be taken until late 2022. The future. The newer Berets are replacing the aging Typhoons with a fleet of at least 8 submarines allocated between the Northern and Pacific fleets. Armed with 16 Bulava missiles, or a total explosive yield of 7,200 kilotons, Berets are nonetheless shorter than their predecessors. With a slightly smaller size of 170 meters, the new submarines are considerably more space efficient. Not to mention, the Bulava is expected to be much more accurate than older versions. Ultimately, the new submarines were designed to reduce the cost of building and maintaining the colossal Typhoons. The 4-decade-old Donskoy is soon to be retired, having been born in an age before computers and compact ballistic missiles existed. Their size was a byproduct of a time when missiles were of enormous dimensions, not only due to the available technologies, but because they seemed more menacing. As weapons become smaller and more accurate, there might never be a class of submarines as large as the Typhoon. But that remains to be seen. Thanks again to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring Dark Seas. Click the link in the description below or scan the QR code to reclaim your unique bonuses. Remember, in Raid Shadow Legends, you must strike hard and strike fast if you want to survive.